We suggest that you can apply at two lenders, his and a competitor. That's how confident he is that he can get you the best deal.
No. That's right, Jimmy Hosman.
This will be mid 80 to 90 for the Valor Diamond AIE. We do have a winter in effect, and even a couple of degrees warmer tomorrow. We'll cool it down a couple of degrees as we go into Saturday and Sunday, and then finally get back into the 60s and 70s by about midweek next week. Healy Local, live from the Kfi 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee. Save big. Go solar American style with Semper Solaris.
Semper Solaris is your local veteran owned solar and battery storage contractor. Add Tesla Powerwall and be ready for blackouts. We get the job done with a free decor and honor. Semper offers new AC systems with a lifetime warranty and new roofs with a 50-year warranty. We hire vets and give back to the community with our Semper Cares initiative. Go solar and declare your independence. No doubt, interest for payments till 2023. Get the federal 26% solar and battery tax credit, $500 downloadable coupon, $500 off for military first responders and healthcare workers. Call 877-211-5591. That's 877-211-5591. Or visit SemperSolaris.com.
By now, you've heard the news. Boosters for Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson vaccines are available. They help keep your immunity strong and help keep you and others protected against COVID-19 and its variants. Visit myturn.ca.gov to find out if you're eligible and to find a booster near you. Let's keep each other safer and healthier this winter. Get your booster, and don't forget to get your flu shot, too. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Advanced Hair Restoration is now offering $250 off and 250 free hair drops for the same simple one-day treatment I receive. Their standard of care always exceeds CDC guidelines, and they guarantee your new hair will grow. Call 844-333-HAIR or go to advancedhair.com.
Bags under your eyes? Work just for you. And Mattress Firm, you can help. Set the Black Friday sale and save up to $500 on top of your brand new mattress. It's easy. Plus, get a mattress of your dreams with a fully adjustable base. It's qualifying purchase.
Visit mechanicars.com before you purchase your new automobile this holiday season. For official rules and more information about contests on this station,
go to kfiam640.com/rules.
Except that Todd Stricker, the DA, is outraged about it.
Yeah. So that's what makes it hard for me to figure out how this happened.
Yeah. Yeah, it is kind of crazy.
Because they were asking for, I think, 7 years.
So if the judge who went down to 6 months?
Well, this is the part I don't understand. The article says that Adam and Drew Jabbar accepted a plea deal from the judge. The prosecutors had sought a 7-year sentence and objected to this offer. So, you know, I would need Todd to explain how this case got away from his office. The group of people trying to get rid of Councilman McCormick and say they have more than enough signatures to force a recall. You have to have 27,000 valid signatures from registered voters in the district, and they have more than 39,000 that they have submitted. So those will be gone over by the city, you know, to make sure that as many of them are valid as possible. And if they do have 27,000 valid signatures, Bonnie's going to face a recall campaign.
Yeah, and it's mainly over homelessness. Although Barnon says he's done more for homeless. He's trying to get as many shelter beds as permanent and medium time housing. It's one side versus the other side. Or is the problem so great that anybody in that position is gone? Oh, by the way, Todd just texted me. It was a plea to the court. The judge undercut, exactly as you said, the judge undercut his prosecutor. And that's why Todd's going back. Knowing Todd,
I think Adam Abdul-Jabbar is going to find himself getting pulled over a lot. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're gonna be watching that guy, looking for other opportunities to haul him back in on something. Anyway, back to Bonnie. Yeah, it's because it's not just the homelessness problem is an abstract issue. It's all the crime and the homeless people setting fires and that kind of stuff that has the residents.
As if another council person is going to be able to do something about it.
Well, I think you're probably right. It almost wouldn't matter who was in the office if that stuff's going on in your neighborhood.
Well, if Percy doesn't succeed, try, and try again. This is a big time.
Big heresy.
The record Van Houten has been recommended by the California Parole Board for parole. She was denied twice by Governor Brown. She's already been denied twice by Governor Newsom. So this will go back to Governor Newsom's desk, but he'll deny it. There's no upside for the governor allowing a parole. It's just for a mansion killer. Even though she was 19 at the time, she's 72 now. You can't very well argue she's still a threat to society. And this is surely a punisher. And my guess is maybe the next couple of go around.
I think this go-around should get back, because I think what's going to happen now is, if Newsom denies it again, they'll appeal his decision to deny it, and this time I think they'll win, because the parole board apparently has had enough of the governor saying no, and they say it's a good parole, and this time, they went through all of the reasons Newsom gave last time, they went through them and addressed it. So Newsom's going to run out of places to hide in terms of why for the governor's parole. When they go to court to review this time, the court's going to say, yeah, you don't really have a valid reason.
But isn't this like a presidential pardon where he has an absolute say?
No, it is reviewable.
All right, let's go ahead and take a break. We'll come back, and we'll finish up by more news on this Veterans Day Thursday. Jennifer Jones.
Well, the investigation into the actual World Festival death could take months, but Houston police chief told reporters detectives are working around the clock with those hours of video to go through. A district attorney in New Mexico is pushing back on claims for deadly shooting on a movie set last month was sabotaged, and the International Space Station is dodging tiny space junk. The ISS Wednesday was forced to maneuver itself to avoid debris from a Chinese weapons test that's been orbiting the Earth since 2007. Watching your ride with Kfi in the sky next.
Life is stressful. I mean, it's that simple. And it's different kinds of stress. During the pandemic is one, now coming back is another.
We're still looking at what's going to happen this winter. So a good night's sleep is always important. And this is where the sleep number 360 smart bed comes in. This is proven quality sleep. It does make a difference. Sleep number bed gives you the great sleep you need because you can adjust, customize each side of the bed to your ideal firmness. That's your sleep number. And mine happens to be 100. I like a firm mattress. And I've changed it with the same bed several times over the last few years. The Veterans Day sale is now going on through November 15th. You can save $1,000 on the Sleep Number 360 Special Edition Smart Bed, plus free premium delivery when you add a base. And you can buy a bed only at a Sleep Number store or on sleepnumber.com. 30 locations in Southern California, including Glendale, Valencia, Huntington Beach, San Dimas. And Sleep Number is the official sleep and wellness partner of the Los Angeles Rams. Sleepnumber.com.
Prime members get Animal Welfare Certified 365 by Whole Foods Market frozen whole turkey for 99 cents a pound through November 25th while supplies last. Limit of 4 turkeys per customer. Learn more on the Whole Foods Market app.
Look at weather from KFI. Sunny for this Veterans Day with highs from the mid-70s at the beaches to the low 90s inland. This report is brought to you by Whole Foods Market. From the Southern California Trader Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy. We're looking at the 10.
You guys have a pretty good drive now if you're leaving downtown Lower County Airport. Coming to the East L.A. interchange, going out to Santa Monica. It's definitely slow from the interchange itself through the 110. But after that, really, by 20 drive centers, I think you'll agree. It's okay. It's a little explosive going this city, but you'll be out to West L.A. Santa Monica before you know it. Even if you turn down 405 going down to LAX, all that is good. Now, some wonderful news. Out of Pasadena, using the southbound 110, down to the 4 level, downtown Los Angeles. The 3rd, 4th, and Wilshire collector lanes were shut down all those off-ramps due to some vegetation fires and all over. Those off-ramps have been reopened. The southbound line shot, really not bad. It's good down to the 5, then a little throw around Hill Street. But after that, you'll be okay. And the South 101 to the South 110, you've got a real slow coming up from Vermont. But again, all that rough is through downtown. We're headed down to 5, more on that. Coming up, this is an announcement. This is Super Run, Super Run, and I'm on the far off AFI in the South.
This report is sponsored by Ashley Home Store. The greatest sale in history is going on now at Ashley Home Store. Take 55% off catalogs for just 55 months, no interest financing. America's number one mattress and furniture store, Ashley Home Store. This is home.
Looking for a good investment? Want to reduce uncertainty, financial risk, and hedge inflation? Here are 8 reasons to consider NIA's Prime Real Estate Development Fund. Steady monthly cash flow payoffs with double-digit targeted returns. Solid, affordable, high-demand home and apartment assets backing. New construction built where housing is badly needed and demand abundant. Substantial properties already built and selling right now supporting them. Short and long-term strategies with steady cash flow and appreciation anticipated. An industry leader with a 15-year track record of 3 million square feet built and a pipeline of $1.7 billion of new property in progress. Hedge against inflation and receive steady cash flow. Start your due diligence at NIA.net or call 800-814-14. That's 800-814-14.
An offer of securities is only made by the NIA private placement number 3-3. That's the benefit of guarantee future results. NIA is the real estate development firm. Learn more at NIA.net.
Spectrum Business is proud to support small businesses with the best internet and phone services at the best value. But we want to do more. So now, for a limited time, get 1 month of services for free. That's right, 1 month on us. Get 200 megabits per second internet and business phone, and even TV, all free for 1 month. Plus, free installation. Call 855-757-4544 or visit spectrum.com/business today. Restrictions apply.
Still love the news, a solar mass panel.
You bet. Saving tons of money. Those panels are going to keep the lights on all through the fall and winter. And because solar mass does everything under one roof right here in Southern California, this is the best for them.
Yeah, solar mass has this exciting new offer. Solar mass has new console 14 panels and power walls for $70.96 per month and zero down.
Dial £250 from your cell phone. Say the key with solar mass. £250, solar mass, or go to solarmaxtech.com. Monthly payment available on approved credit. The SLB number 97304.
I had 3 surgeons pass away from COVID-19. One of them I was very close to. These guys taught me how to get on the line as a football player. What I think to do is, and I'm getting back, whether it's that whether it's their own life or the people that are around. Take it from me, the vaccine saves lives. Find a vaccine near you at myturn.ca.gov. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
What is a veteran? A veteran is an American dedicated to their country, willing to lay down their life for our freedom so that we may all enjoy life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. These brave individuals are well deserving of our respect and appreciation each and every day. This November 11th, in honor of Veterans Day, Theater Brothers salutes all veterans and their families for their generous sacrifice and service to our great nation. Our heartfelt thanks to you from Theater Brothers Market.
Don't wait. Get ready for the holidays now during Court Furniture Outlet's annual Black Friday event, where everything is on sale at the lowest prices of the year. At Court Furniture Outlet, you'll find everything you need to brighten up your home or make your workplace more comfortable. And the best part is that it's all in stock and ready for immediate delivery. So no waiting. Now during Court Furniture Outlet's Black Friday event, you'll save on a huge selection of new upholstery in several styles and colors, including sectionals and sleepers, dining sets, bedroom sets, and mattresses. What's great deals on office furniture. Comfortable Mustang office chairs, originally $249, now only $59. Rugs for $50, action pillows $5, and all legwork 50% off. Come in today and discover why Core Furniture Outlet has been the secret destination of designers, home stagers, and business professionals for over 30 years. With locations in Glendale and Central, in Corona at the 91 McKinley, and now Fountain Valley at Euclid in the 405. Check them out on Yelp or go to CoreFurnitureOutlet.com. That's CoreFurnitureOutlet.com.
When the title was out to Jimmy's teacher's spring of this year,
she was there all the time.
She was there to take care of Grandpa.
One of the theories, maybe she felt that White House, they weren't doing a good job of explaining what it was that Kamala Harris had been doing. If the White House can't even describe it, then how are we supposed to describe it on KFI? Coming up at 8 o'clock. It's a Handle History segment. It's fascinating. And a question that you don't know the answer. I'll say that right now. Let's begin. Now, let's return to finish up handling the news with Jennifer Wayne and me.
Ghislaine Maxwell, once again, loses in court. The Jeffrey Epstein associate on trial for all kinds of charges. Didn't want to let the prosecution put on an expert witness, a psychologist named Lisa Rocchio, who specializes in treating patients who suffered from sexual abuse. She will testify about how it is very common for victims of sexual abuse not to report it until much later in their life, amongst other things. Well, the defense wants to attack all of these accusers any way they can. If any of them have any history of drug abuse, they're going to go after them for that one. They're going to try to attack them for why did you wait so long. This expert will say, it's totally normal that people wait a long time. They don't want the jury to hear it. The judge says, yeah, they're going to hear it. And a lot of people understand that a good part of the trial is what happens before the trial, when motions are brought before the court in terms of evidence. That's what happened yesterday in the Rittenhouse, where a motion was made by the prosecution early on to include evidence. The judge said no, and then the prosecutor brought it up in the middle of the trial. The judge went for sure. And the request for a mistrial, that may or may not fly, but the prosecutors want a mistrial with prejudice, which will never happen. Not with that. That was just a mistrial, new jury, new case starts in the beginning, that's all. You dismiss the case or you declare a mistrial and it's over. No.
Oh, that's what the defense will want, right? That you cannot try and do it. That will not happen.
That's correct.
All right, there was a guy from New Jersey who owns a gym there. His name's Scott Fairman. And he was caught on body cam at the riot at the Capitol in January, shoving a cop and punching him in the face. Now, this guy pleaded guilty to the charges. He now is the first rioter to get sentenced, and he got 41 months in prison.
Oh, 3.5 years. That's no joke.
To the 120 other rioters that are facing sentencing now or facing trial. Is this that sort of a benchmark, a baseline?
That's what the judge said. The judge said, yeah, you're going to be prepared or be prepared for a lot of heavy sentences. Also, what makes his case particularly egregious is he punches the cop in the face, and he's a mixed martial artist. Like, the guy is really good at punching people. So I think that had a fair amount to do with it. Or at least, no. Hate crimes are up. What a surprise. L.A. County data is out. Hate crimes are up 20%, according to this data. Black people disproportionately targeted in hate crimes. They're 42% of the victims of hate crimes, when they're only 9% of the county population. Asians also disproportionately. And guess who is up and coming in the world of being a hate crime victim? White people. Hate crimes against white people also up. However, the difference is the number of actual incidents very, very, very low.
I want to point something out. Is,
I mean, all of these are arguably low,
right,
numerically compared to a population of 10 million people.
That's true. So they don't, usually that's not mentioned when covering stories like this. But what I want to mention is that everything follows politics, the polarization, even hate crime. It used to be Muslims whenever there was a terrorist attack. Now Black Lives Matter and the hatred towards African Americans, hate crimes there. It's pretty crazy how hate crimes follow the politics, even hate crimes.
Yeah, let me put the number out just so people understand. LA County, about 10 million, roughly, in population. The number of total hate crimes we're talking about in this report for 2020, 635.
All right. So you were talking about Rustler Sam, one of the mascots, and I think we're going to talk a little bit more about Rustler Sam. But we've got another story about a mascot, and this is the Colonist mascot. So 4 years after the Anaheim School District decided to rebrand one mascot, now they've got a different question. They, in 2017, changed Johnny Rebel because they didn't want to have a connection to the Confederacy. But on Wednesday, students at the school, at Anaheim High School, announced the results of a campus-wide vote on whether to keep or get rid of the Colonist mascot, and they want to keep the Colonist mascot.
It's a pilgrim! What are they going to say about pilgrims? What did the pilgrims do to the Native Americans?
Aha! So, therefore, we want to get rid of pilgrims.
But 41% of the student body said, let's keep the name, let's keep the mascot. 34% said, we can keep the name, but let's not have the logo be a pilgrim with two guns. And then 25% said, let's get something completely new down here. So I guess the column is
at least that's a slight win for what I consider a good guy. It reminds me of Ole Miss, the college, changed its mascot from the Rebel. Then now they went to I forget what the cool dude's name was, Roddy something, and then they didn't like that one. So now they are the Land Sharks.
Wow. That's dumb.
Oh, yeah, that is really
that, that's
stupid.
That's my reaction.
Really,
that's dumb.
Yeah, that
right.
Really is.
So, yeah. And it's not cool dumb like the banana slug, which is actually cool in a way. It's just dumb dumb.
Yeah, it is. And how do you navigate those waters? What name can you possibly come up with that doesn't offend someone someplace?
Well, that you have to create a thing that doesn't actually exist, like the Philly.
Yeah.
Like the Philly mascot. That's not a thing from the real world. That's what you have to do. Yes, you can go like the Gavanga Gonzo Man, and it's just some crazy cartoon character and has no history.
Guys, we're done. Coming up, the Kyle Rittenhouse case, what happened yesterday, and some different pieces of it. This is KFI AM 640 Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
KFI.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Honoring no concerns.
I'm Senator Jen 3 live from the KFI 24 hour newsroom. Veterans in LA County will now be able to get more help in moments of crisis.
The county's mental health department has partnered with other agencies to create a so-called rally point for veterans and their families to go for help. There's one rally point in each of the five county supervisors' districts where veterans can go for help for mental health and substance use disorders, housing assistance, healthcare access, workforce development and training. Every veteran
eligible for financial stability,
time in service, or service record. See forever clarifying this.
Yeah.
He said he now serves as a board member for